At the age of 21, she beat her younger brother in a battle to become the Queen of Egypt. Even though she had Greek roots, she fully embraced Egyptian traditions. For centuries, researchers have been intensely searching for Queen Cleopatra's tomb. And guess what? They just found it. Not only did they discover her tomb, but they also uncovered secrets about that ancient civilization. How did archaeologists pinpoint the exact location of the tomb? What hints guided them there? Let's find out. Cleopatra VII was part of the Macedonian dynasty that took over the rule of Egypt in the late 4th century BC. During her reign, she forged political alliances and became romantically involved with Roman military leaders Julius Caesar and Mark Antony, until her death in 30 BC. One of antiquity's most famous rulers, Cleopatra's life inspired William Shakespeare's play, Antony and Cleopatra, and numerous film dramatizations, most famously, a 1963 feature starring Elizabeth Taylor. The last ruler of the Macedonian dynasty, Cleopatra VII, Thea Philopater, was born around 69 BC. The line of rule was established in 323 BC, following the death of Alexander the Great. The era began when Alexander's general, Ptolemy, took over as ruler of Egypt, becoming King Ptolemy I, Soter of Egypt. Over the next three centuries, his descendants would follow in his path. At its height, Ptolemaic Egypt was one of the world's great powers. Cleopatra's father was King Ptolemy XII. Little is known about Cleopatra's mother, but some speculation presume she may have been her father's sister, Cleopatra V, Tryphaena. Debate also surrounds Cleopatra's ethnicity, as some suggest she may have, in part, been descended from black Africans. In 51 BC, Ptolemy XII died, leaving the throne to 18-year-old Cleopatra and her brother, the 10-year-old Ptolemy XIII. It's likely that the two siblings married, as was customary at the time. Over the next few years, Egypt struggled to face a number of issues, from an unhealthy economy to floods and famine. Political turmoil also shaped this period. Soon after they assumed power, complications arose between Cleopatra and Ptolemy XIII. Eventually, Cleopatra fled to Syria, where she assembled an army to defeat her rival in order to declare the throne for herself. In 48 BC, she returned to Egypt with her military might and faced her brother at Pelusium, located on the empire's eastern edge. Around the same time, the civil war between military leaders Julius Caesar and Pompey was consuming Rome. Pompey eventually sought refuge in Egypt, but, on orders of Ptolemy, was killed. In pursuit of his rival, Caesar followed Pompey into Egypt, where he met and eventually fell in love with Cleopatra. In Caesar, Cleopatra now had access to enough military muscle to dethrone her brother and solidify her grip on Egypt as sole ruler. Following Caesar's defeat of Ptolemy's forces at the Battle of the Nile, Caesar restored Cleopatra to the throne. Cleopatra eventually followed Caesar back to Rome, but returned to Egypt in 44 BC, following his assassination. In 41 BC, Mark Antony, part of the second triumvirate that ruled Rome following the murder of Caesar, sent for Cleopatra so that she could answer questions about her allegiance to the empire's fallen leader. Cleopatra agreed to his request and made a lavish entrance into the city of Tarsus, Sicilia. Captivated by her beauty and personality, Antony plunged into a love affair with Cleopatra. Like Caesar before him, Antony was embroiled in a battle over Rome's control. His rival was Caesar's own great-nephew, Gaius Octavius, also known as Octavian, and later as Emperor Caesar Augustus. Octavian, along with Marcus Aemilius Lepidus, rounded out the second triumvirate. Antony, who presided over Rome's eastern areas, saw in Cleopatra the chance for financial and military support to secure his own rule over the empire. Cleopatra had her own motivations as well. In exchange for her help, she sought the return of Egypt's eastern empire, which included large areas of Lebanon and Syria. In 34 BC, Antony returned with Cleopatra to Alexandria with a triumphant flair. Crowds swarmed to the gymnasium to catch a glimpse of the couple seated on golden thrones that were elevated on silver platforms. Beside them sat their children. Antony antagonized his rival by declaring Caesarion as Caesar's real son and legal heir, rather than Octavian, whom the revered Roman leader had adopted. Octavian fought back, declaring he'd seized Antony's will, and told the Roman people that Antony had turned over Roman possessions to Cleopatra and was planning to make Alexandria the Roman capital. In 31 BC, Cleopatra and Antony combined armies to try to defeat Octavian in a raging sea battle at Actium, off Greece's west coast. The clash, however, proved to be a costly defeat for the Egyptians, forcing Antony and Cleopatra to flee back to Egypt. After suffering a crushing defeat at the hands of Roman rival Octavian, Mark Antony, believing Cleopatra to be dead, killed himself. Cleopatra followed by also committing suicide, supposedly by being bitten by an asp, although the truth is unknown. After her death, on August 12, 30 BC, Cleopatra was buried alongside Antony in a yet-to-be-discovered location. Following Cleopatra's death, Egypt became a province of the Roman Empire. While classical writers' accounts suggest Cleopatra's physician, Olympos, documented her death without specifying the cause, the story evolved and is now widely accepted the involvement of an Egyptian cobra called an asp. Strabo and early sources, claiming to have witnessed Cleopatra's suicide or were present in Alexandria at the time, wrote a century later, likely drawing from Olympos's historical account. According to the tale, Cleopatra had an asp brought to her concealed within a basket of figs. Allowing the deadly serpent to bite her sealed her tragic fate. The recorded date of her death is thought to be either August 10th or 12th, 30 BCE. Another theory suggests a more sinister plot, proposing that Octavian engineered Cleopatra's demise to solidify his grip on the empire. Some speculate that she might have chosen to end her life through poisoning, while others even suggest suffocation by placing a bag over her head. Unfortunately, given only fragmentary accounts and no concrete evidence, the actual circumstances of Cleopatra's death remain elusive. We are left with conjectures, prompting us to ponder if the complete story will ever come to light. Adding to the sorrow surrounding Cleopatra's passing is the mystery shrouding her final resting place. Despite more than two millennia passing, the tomb of Antony and Cleopatra had yet to be uncovered, leaving historians and geologists fascinated as they search for clues to uncover this mystery. Now let's discuss the burial of Cleopatra and Antony. Following their defeat in 30 BC, the Roman leader Octavian allowed Cleopatra and Antony to be interred together. Conversely, their children were brought to Rome to be raised as Roman citizens. It's believed that Emperor Augustus consented to Cleopatra being laid to rest with her lover Antony, likely undergoing mummification to preserve their bodies. According to the historian Plutarch, Antony and Cleopatra found their final resting place in Cleopatra's mausoleum. Antony was then laid to rest in the mausoleum. 2 weeks later, Cleopatra passed away and joined him in the mausoleum. Now the true mystery unfolds. People believe that their tomb is somewhere in Alexandria, Egypt. One theory suggests it's in or near a temple called Taposiris Magna, southwest of Alexandria. The Egyptian Antiquity Service supports this idea. But wait, there's more. Another theory proposes that Cleopatra might have chosen a place called the Royal Necropolis, a sacred burial ground on the western side of the Red Sea. That's an interesting twist, isn't it? Of course, there have been other suggestions about where the tomb might be, but Alexandria remains the most popular guess. It's like a big puzzle waiting to be solved, but so far, nobody has found their final resting place. In the pursuit of uncovering Cleopatra's tomb, archaeologists have been on a persistent mission for almost two decades. Their unwavering dedication has recently yielded some promising discoveries, providing a glimmer of hope. The methods employed in this quest range from meticulous excavations at various Egyptian sites, particularly the Taposiris Magna Temple, to cutting-edge technology. Interesting clues, including the identification of a massive tunnel, have emerged from these excavations. Additionally, archaeologists have harnessed geophysical surveys to scan the underground landscape, searching for hidden structures or anomalies that might indicate the presence of a tomb. Ground-penetrating radar has played a pivotal role, allowing them to delve beneath the surface and detect potential signs of concealed chambers or structures. Moreover, satellite imagery has been examined, scrutinizing the Earth's surface for peculiarities or structures that might be linked to Cleopatra's tomb. However, the quest for Cleopatra's tomb doesn't solely rely on modern techniques. Historians have dived deep into ancient texts and documents, meticulously sifting through historical accounts in a quest for clues that might reveal the location of a concealed tomb. Guess what? The efforts of archaeologists have paid off, leading to an exceptionally exciting and unexpected discovery at Taposiris Magna in Egypt. This has given rise to the theory circulating that Cleopatra and Mark Antony might indeed be buried at that place, with some intriguing evidence supporting this notion. In a tomb in Taposiris, archaeologists found two mummies. Initially, these archaeologists encountered challenges identifying the mummies due to significant damage. Nonetheless, persistently, they took x-rays of the mummies, revealing one as a man and the other as a woman. But it gets even more fascinating. There's a theory suggesting that these mummies could have been priests crucial in maintaining the pharaohs in power. One of the mummies features a scarab image painted with gold leaf. The scarab symbolizes rebirth, acting as a clue pointing towards something special. This discovery is regarded as sensational because it highlights the significance of the Taposiris Magna necropolis. Now, let's dive into history. Taposiris Magna, constructed in the 3rd century BC by Pharaoh Ptolemy II Philadelphus, was no ordinary city. The Taposiris Magna Temple, dedicated to the god of death and the afterlife, Osiris, was a geometric marvel, spanning an impressive 1,305 meters in length and standing at a modest 2 meters tall. This tunnel, a testament to design and engineering, mirrors the renowned Upolinos Tunnel in Greece, showcasing a monumental achievement. Though we can't say with certainty, the evidence discovered at Taposiris Magna adds a hint of optimism to the notion that Cleopatra and Mark Antony may have found their final resting place there. Who knows what other remarkable treasures and secrets might await discovery at Taposiris Magna? Let's hope for some more surprising revelations. Dr. Kathleen Martinez, a Dominican lawyer, archaeologist, and diplomat, has dedicated 14 years to unveiling the long-lost tomb of Cleopatra. Her efforts, starting in 2004, when she contacted renowned archaeologist Zahi Hawass, have been nothing short of remarkable. Exploring various temples, Dr. Martinez sensed that Taposiris Magna held the key to her quest, fueling her determination to explore this ancient site. For 14 years, Dr. Martinez and her team tirelessly dug into the earth at Taposiris Magna, uncovering a wealth of artifacts she believes is linked to Cleopatra herself. Among their remarkable findings is a concealed burial chamber hidden beneath the Egyptian sands for centuries, containing not just one, not two, but 10 mummies in 27 tombs belonging to Egyptian nobles. The identities of these mummies remain unknown. It's a puzzle awaiting resolution. Nevertheless, the discovery of this burial chamber is significant. Now the plot thickens. Amid these tombs, Martinez stumbled upon coins bearing images of Cleopatra. Can you believe it? As if that's not enough, carvings depicting Cleopatra and Mark Antony in a loving embrace were also uncovered. The most astonishing breakthrough occurred in 2022, when Dr. Martinez's team stumbled upon an extensive and incredible tunnel hidden beneath the Temple of Osiris at Taposiris Magna. This find sparked hope within Dr. Martinez, as she believed this tunnel might be the key to unveiling Cleopatra's lost tomb. The anticipation heightened as they delved deeper underground. Dr. Martinez faced skepticism from the archaeological community, as historical records indicated that Taposiris Magna had no tunnels. Undeterred, she led an excavation beneath the Taposiris Magna Temple. The team's astonishing discoveries, including coins, skeletons, mummies, burial rooms, and tablets with the temple's name, silenced the skeptics and injected fresh energy into the quest for Cleopatra's tomb. Now, let me break it down. While these discoveries have stirred up chatter in the archaeological community, there's still some uncertainty. Experts are debating whether Martinez's findings in the temple pinpoint the exact burial spot of Cleopatra and Mark Antony. Plutarch, who mentioned their joint burial, wasn't specific about a location, adding a layer of complexity. Things are taking an interesting turn. Brace yourself for another intriguing find. Dr. Martinez's team recently stumbled upon a statue atop Osiris Magna, and it's not your run-of-the-mill statue. It's a headless statue of King Ptolemy IV, who governed Egypt from 221 to 204 BC. Why is this statue significant? It's like a crucial piece of the historical puzzle, offering a glimpse into the world of the Ptolemaic dynasty, the rulers who held sway. It's akin to discovering a concealed treasure that opens up a whole new section of the history books. Keep your excitement levels up, because this is just the start. With each revelation, we inch closer to unraveling the mysteries of the past. Who knows what other secrets are buried beneath these ancient sands? Recently, archaeologists near Alexandria, Egypt, uncovered something remarkable, a hidden tunnel beneath the Temple of Osiris Magna. As they delved deeper, an astonishing array of sanctuaries, and even a sacred lake came to light. This extraordinary site yielded over 1,500 objects, including busts, statues, and golden pieces that adorned the area. Now for the intriguing part. Right where priests would have presented offerings to the gods, an extraordinary find emerged. 200 coins featuring none other than Cleopatra's name and her beautiful face, the same as those unearthed by Dr. Martinez at this very temple site. These coins likely served as offerings, establishing a direct link between Cleopatra and the temple. Can you sense the excitement building? Can you see how all the pieces of the puzzle are starting to fit together? But what does it all signify? Well, it suggests that Cleopatra played a significant role in the temple's history. The discovery, coupled with a hidden tunnel, adds another layer of fascination, hinting that her final resting place might be near the Temple of Osiris in the ancient city of Taposiris Magna. Thrilling, isn't it? The connection between Cleopatra and this temple grows clearer and more captivating with each new revelation. Who knows what other secrets might be waiting to be uncovered? Consider this captivating theory about Cleopatra's tomb. she may have entrusted her remains to the temple priests. Dr. Martinez suggests that Cleopatra might have found her final resting place in the Temple of Osiris in the ancient city of Taposiris Magna, situated on Egypt's northern coast, where the Nile River meets the Mediterranean. Martinez proposes that Cleopatra selected this temple because it symbolized her connection to the goddess Isis, whom she regarded herself as being in human form. Interestingly, Cleopatra's lover Antony was believed to embody the god Osiris, Isis's husband, creating a real-life myth. Some experts even speculate that her tomb could be concealed underwater, adding an element of mystery. Will the temple unveil its secrets, and could Cleopatra's tomb lie submerged? Now let's explore the challenges hindering the discovery of the tomb. Can artifacts be reliable evidence in the quest for Cleopatra's tomb? Well, like anything else, they come with their advantages and drawbacks. Let's delve into the limitations of using artifacts in this intriguing pursuit. Firstly, there's the issue of missing artifacts. Some may have deteriorated over time, suffered damage during excavation, or simply disappeared, leaving gaps in the evidence. It's akin to solving a puzzle with some pieces missing. Another obstacle is the uniqueness of any artifacts. Their one-of-a-kind nature makes it challenging for archaeologists to analyze and authenticate them. It's akin to deciphering a secret code without any reference points. Accurately dating artifacts isn't a straightforward task either. The archaeological evidence often presents a challenging puzzle of time, making it difficult to establish the context and significance of the artifact. It's akin to constructing a historical timeline with missing dates. Adding to this complexity, most artifacts decay with time. Numerous archaeological sites remain untouched, leaving us with only a fraction of the available evidence. Moreover, archaeological information is susceptible to inaccuracy. Conclusions and reconstructions rely on limited evidence, making it challenging to trace artifacts back to their original context. Despite these challenges, artifacts can still provide valuable insights into the quest for Cleopatra's tomb. However, archaeologists must be mindful of these limitations and approach the evidence with caution and an open mind. Now let's delve into some natural factors that can further complicate the reliability of artifacts as evidence. Exposure to certain elements over time can weather artifacts. Chemical reactions and biological processes can contribute to deterioration. Then there's the matter of burial. While burying artifacts in the ground might seem like a good idea, it can lead to damage and degradation over time. The excavation process also matters. Mishandling precious artifacts during excavation can result in damage or contamination, obscuring their true narrative. It's akin to mishandling delicate artifacts and unintentionally erasing their secrets. Consider the aspect of perishability. Materials like wood, leather, and textiles, being organic, are highly susceptible to decay and unable to withstand the test of time. Additionally, there's the issue of incomplete evidence. Many archaeological sites remain untouched, and even those excavated may not have divulged all the evidence that once existed, resembling the challenge of solving a puzzle with only a few scattered pieces. These inherent factors introduce a twist in the reliability of artifacts as evidence. Archaeologists must meticulously weigh the context of artifact discoveries and lean on multiple lines of evidence to substantiate their conclusions. It's akin to assembling a vast historical puzzle where each clue holds significance. As we embark on the captivating journey in search of Cleopatra's tomb, let's approach artifacts with enthusiasm and anticipation. Despite their limitations, they retain the potential to unveil the secrets of the past. It's said that Cleopatra, once a figure of great power and influence, is now shrouded in history's obscurity. We can only wish for the discovery of her tomb one day, unveiling the mystery of her final resting place. Considering the advancements in archaeology, do you believe that we're on the verge of discovering Cleopatra's tomb? Or do you speculate it may have succumbed to decay under unfavorable conditions? What if she deliberately chose an inaccessible burial place, concealing her tomb from discovery? What are your thoughts on this? Let us know in the comments section below and subscribe for more.